come on down.
Yes,
come on down. It's okay. I love your Elsa purse and your it's a doctor kit. Oh, maybe don't take my blood pressure today, but that's okay. So we are so glad you're here this morning. Thanks for coming. I'm going to ask you a question. How many of you here are afraid of snakes? I'll raise my hand big. I'm afraid of snakes.
No, not me, because
I don't like snakes. Yeah. How about, are you afraid of the dark?
Not me.
Not you? Because you're seven, so you're not afraid of the dark? Okay.
We play hide and seek in the dark.
You play hide and seek in the dark?
Oh, yeah, and Eloise and Josie.
Oh, my goodness.
Even fighting pillows in the dark.
Oh, well, you have pillow fights in the dark? Well, I aren't supposed to, but... Okay, how about, are you afraid of thunderstorms? Are you afraid of thunderstorms? The lightning and the noise, that's kind of scary, isn't it? So there are a lot of things that people are afraid of.
Even the lightning wakes
me up. Yes, the lightning and the thunder can wake you up. Do you know that there are some famous people who are afraid of things? How many of you know Johnny Depp? You know who Johnny Depp is? Who does the Pirates of the Caribbean? He is afraid of clowns. Are you afraid of clowns?
Oh, yeah, like Pennywise.
Yes, you're afraid of clowns. How many of you are afraid of heights, of high things?
Oh, yeah, because I don't like planes.
You don't like to fall, like the planes, yes?
Yeah, because I don't want to go skydiving.
You don't want to go skydiving? I don't either. Don't worry about that. Okay. Well, there's a famous football coach, John Madden. He was so afraid of flying that he bought his own bus. And he spent $800,000 on a bus so he wouldn't have to travel on a plane. That's kind of crazy. Now, how many of you are afraid of bugs? Yes.
Yeah, because I hate spiders.
You hate spiders?
Because they can bite you.
Yeah, spiders aren't my favorite either. Well, here's something funny.
Not me.
Scarlett Johansson doesn't like cockroaches. I don't either. Nicole Kidman doesn't like butterflies. That's kind of silly. And Justin Timberlake doesn't like spiders. You agree with him?
Well,
Spider-Man's a nice guy, though. So, yeah. So one day in our Bible story this morning, we're going to hear about how Jesus was with the disciples, and the disciples were commenting on how beautiful the temple was. And Jesus began to tell them about some of the things that were going to happen. He told them that the temple would be destroyed and that there would be earthquakes and wars. He told them that people would hate them because they believed in Jesus and they would even be thrown in prison. Those are pretty scary things, aren't they?
Oh, yes, even Chucky dolls.
Well, we'll talk about that later, Chucky dolls. Okay, so it'd be understandable for the disciples and us to be afraid. But guess what Jesus said? Jesus said, don't be afraid, because he would be with them and that not a hair on their heads would be harmed if they put their trust in Jesus. Now, Jesus also promised to help us when we're afraid. I mean, everybody, we talked about this a few minutes ago, everybody is afraid of something. And fear can sometimes be a good thing, but we shouldn't let our fears keep us from enjoying our life that Jesus wants us to have. After all, Jesus promised to help us when we're afraid. So let's say a quick prayer, and then you all can go to Children's Church if you want with Miss Kim back there. So let's, after the prayer, you get the candy, remember? Okay, so let's say a prayer. Dear Jesus, we put our faith, and our trust, in your promise, to be with us, when we are afraid. Amen. Okay, you can get some candy. I know.
Candy.
That's enough. Okay. And then, Kim, we're gonna candy him up and send him your way, okay? So here you go. Want some candy? You dropped it. There you go. You can have some candy. We're getting kind of low. Pastor Chuck needs to get some restocking done. And maybe a surprise next week, too, for Thanksgiving. We'll have to see what I can find.
I got this for my dad.
That's okay. You can have that for your dad. That is wonderful to take that for your dad. There you go. Thank you for coming down so much. love having these kids. You know, it's one of those things, you never know what's going to happen. And now we'll have the reading of our scripture. We'll have Miss Brenda come.